saw more than 3 inches of rainfall in much of the city. CBS 2 reporter Chelsea Irving describes the Des Plaines River near Bolingbrook.
It is swollen well past where it normally is, to the point of treetops now poking up out of the river. And moving along down this road, extensive street flooding in this area after 2 days of rain, and the rain has been going on and off again this morning, so this is going to continue.
We're expecting passing showers today. AccuWeather meteorologist Elliot Abrams will have the full 5-day forecast live at 8:14.
Chicago is expanding a project that offers extra security for teenagers during the summer. The Summer Safe Passage Program started up last year at 21 Park District locations. That will increase to 31, serving more than 3,000 teenagers as they travel to and from summer recreation programs.
WBBM News Time, 8:08. Traffic and weather together on the 8th, sponsored by Lakeside Bank. Here's Bo Durant.
Well, we start off with a serious crash. This is in Aurora, and it's on Butterfield Road between DuPage Parkway and Eola. Multiple injuries there, so you're advised to avoid the area. Butterfield Road between DuPage Parkway and Eola. You also just heard the report about flooding and high standing water. We still have some closures because of flooding from over the weekend. That includes in Palos Hills, eastbound 107th from LaGrange to Keene. Also in Glen Ellen, Route 53 remains closed between Butterfield and Park, and Royce between Route 53 and Green remains blocked as well. Eden's inbound 25 minutes from Lake Cook to the junction 26, back out to Lake Cook Road. The inbound Kennedy is still an hour 17 from O'Hare to downtown. It's 40 minutes from Montrose, and that's the locals. 30 in the express lanes are going to save you some time inbound. The outbound side of Kennedy, 38 out to Montrose and 58 out to O'Hare. Inbound Ike, an hour 10 from Thorndale, 50 in from Mannheim. Outbound is an hour 2 back out to Thorndale. Stevenson inbound, a crash on the California exit ramp. It's an hour 5. 355 into Lakeshore Drive, 54 minutes in from the Tri-State outbound 28, back out from the Tri-State 38 out to 355. The northbound 55 delays start for Route 126 onto the Stevenson. The Dan Ryan inbound 38 minutes from 95th into downtown, 57 inbound, 28-minute commute from I-80 into the Dan Ryan. We should report it down slow from 159th to Dalton. Earlier crash now on the shoulder there, 28 minutes from 80-94 into the Ryan. Lakeshore Drive northbound slow from Grand Park. Southbound is tight, Addison North, and then from 80 to the Stevenson.
Northbound side of the Tri-State, stop and go from Southwest Highway up to 31st, 88 to the outbound 290 ramp, 88 to the Grand Avenue curve. Yep, the sun is back, at least for now. Gunsonville Bridge to Balmoral around I-90. Oakton to the eastbound Dempster exit, southbound 120 to the Lake Forest Oasis backed up around 60. Balmoral across Bensonville Bridge. 90 eastbound to Rampton to O'Hare is the only thing that's backed up there. Eastbound 88, Fox River most of the way to 59, moving slow. Naperville to Yackley after that, 53 north, 355 before Highland to Midwest and York. On the northbound Tri-State ramp, 355, 53 northbound's been ugly, still is, past I-55 to the east 88 ramp, Argonne Hill toll plaza all the way up to the Higgins exit. Got some utility work going on Higgins around the road, at least in that area. The lanes are reduced, so watch for that. Southbound around the Kirchhoff, a little bit around Roosevelt, the 390's okay. Chris, 107, 88
eastbound slow, Larkin to the river, traffic moving together on the 8s every 10 minutes on News Radio 780.